Back with another NBC Hoops Shoot Around brought to you by Purina. He's Adam Emenecker and I'm Kelly Burke. And we have 3 weeks left in the Valley regular season. And Adam, a pair of surging teams right now in SIU and Bradley. SIU in second place and Bradley in a three-way tie for third right now.
Yeah, and how about two-thirds of the way through the season to have a logjam? It seems like we have this every year. So only one game separating the third place team and the eighth place team at the time of this recording. And, you know, I tell you, one team that's kind of going in the other direction, Missouri State's kind of in free fall. But you look at SIU and Bradley, the Salukis have won five in a row. They're a top 100 RPI team right now. And the last time, so five in a row, the last time they won five straight NBC games, go back to 06-07 when they won 10 in a row and went to the Sweet 16. So Barry Henson's got this group really playing well. And, you know, you mentioned Bradley as well, Kelly. How about a team under Brian Wardle that's grown so much over the last 3 years, coming off their first home loss of the year to Drake, and previously they won four straight. You really like to see the progression, like out of guys like Elijah Childs, keeps getting better, and it's allowing people like Daryl Brown not just to be a scorer, but to be a facilitator. And they're so tough on the defensive end that as this team is getting better on the offensive side, they're really tough to beat.
Yeah, well, and these two teams, interestingly enough, meet on Sunday. We'll take on each other, so that should be a great upcoming matchup. You know, let's flip to the other side of things. We have Missouri State, who's kind of going the opposite direction right now. You know, they've lost five in a row. You feel bad for them in this sense. They had this free cryotherapy incident a couple weeks ago and have a couple guys sidelined from it.
Right. I mean, not something you can ever anticipate as a coach or a training staff, and just really unfortunate to see, and to not have Reggie Scurry on the inside and all the stuff that he's brought to that offense, and having Fofana out just really decreases their depth a little bit. But and really odd to see a team that a lot of people pick towards the top of the league this year to be slipping into that Thursday night seed around our Arch Madness season, two-thirds of the way through the year. But one of the other keys is Alize Johnson. He almost looks human, right? So if you look at his last five games, he's averaging 13 points to 9 rebounds. That's good for most people. The previous five games for him, 20 points per game and 16 rebounds. So look for him to start getting on track. He's a great player. He won't be held down for too long.
Do you think those numbers slipping, is it more what opposing defenses are doing, or just more, you know, something with himself?
Yeah, I think the pace of the game has slowed down a little bit. They've struggled on the offensive side, especially without Scurry in there. There's a lot more focus on Alize Johnson. Not that you couldn't focus on him before. Everybody did. And also, you know, Kelly, you're bound to come down to earth. 20 points and 16 rebounds, that's rarefied air in college basketball. And Alize Johnson, to be able to do it as consistently as he has, and, you know, to be honest, 13 and 9 ain't bad, right? So he's still putting up good numbers. They're just not otherworldly numbers like we're used to seeing out of him.
Well, let's give a shout out to a Drake player, you know, who had a pretty big career milestone this past weekend.
Yeah, we mentioned the win over Bradley, Drake snapping their undefeated home streak and the four straight that the Braves won. And congratulations to Reed Timmer. How about it? The all-time leading scorer in Drake University. Really rare to be able to experience something like that and just be able to see a guy do it so well over the course of his four-year career. And not only the pair, the individual success and accolades with what they're experiencing as a team in the top half of the league, halfway or two-thirds of the way through the season right now, the big surprise of the conference has to be the Drake Bulldogs.
Absolutely, and I feel like Reed Timmer is like 25 years old. It feels like he's been in the league forever, but it's it's great to see him having a great senior season, you know, as you mentioned, team-wise too. You know,
yeah, sure.
And then finally, you know, Loyola, just sitting atop the conference standings right now, and a point guard in Clayton Custer that, you know, is really driving the ship there.
Yeah, and I mean, of course, the team we didn't mention is the one that just ho-hum is on top of the conference and leading the whole thing. And, you know, it's one of the best offensive teams we've seen in recent history in this league, just clicking on all cylinders. And you mentioned Clayton Custer. He's the key to that whole thing. When he was out, they struggled. No surprise, right? You lose your starting point guard. But what he means to that team, not only with his scoring prowess, but his ability to distribute the basketball. Before they lost at Bradley last week, they'd won seven in a row themselves. So this Loyola team is hot as anybody in the country, and I guarantee you, come March Madness time, no one's going to want to see the Ramblers, especially what they did earlier in the year against Florida.
Yeah, and an interesting stat, you know, since he returned January 7th, Custer, they're 8-1 in the Valley, and they're 17-2 with him this season when he plays.
Yeah, you got to imagine that puts him right at the top of the conversation for Conference Player of the Year, and well-deserved. He's had an awesome season.
Well, this has been the NBC Hoops Shootaround brought to you by Purina Dog Chow, always crafted in the USA since 1926.